各位观众朋友，大家好，欢迎收看我们休士顿论坛，我是马健。我今天很开心，我们的好朋友施瑞库卡尼能够上我们的节目。我知道现在选举这个很急迫，现在尤其是我们的选区。我认识施瑞很久了，我想让大家能够再认识他一下，尤其是各位如果在休士顿地区有亲戚有朋友的，可以打电话再催一下票。Sri, I was just telling our audience, I've known you for quite a while. I still remember the first time I met you. You just started, you moved back to Houston, you didn't know a single person in the industry. Literally, you just attended all the Chinese events, one by one, introduced yourself one by one, and you have not stopped in 3 years. You still attend every event.
Yeah, no. For me, it's a big deal to make sure that we make that connection, especially because our community, the Asian community writ large, that's how we pull people together one by one. We pull all of our communities together because when I was growing up here, I didn't see those kind of examples. I didn't see someone who looked like me or from any Asian community as a city councilman or a congressman or a governor or anything like that. And so that personal attention is very important to me. But 我可以介绍一下我自己吗
当然，当然，please。
各位好，我叫苏瑞库卡尼，英文名字是 Sri Preston Kulkarni，竞选美国国会议员，拜托你们支持我，投我的票。如今，我们国家已经超过5000万的人失去工作，超过20万人死于新冠病毒。在这危难的时刻，我们最需要的是英明的领导和全国的团结。
Wow, I can't believe you still remember how to speak Mandarin Chinese. 还记得怎么讲？
我在台湾住了2年，从2004年到2006年，对，所以已经超过了14年。
施瑞他本身原来是外交官。他是这个我们的 epitome of the Asian American dream. It really the American dream. He went to Ivy League schools. He got a really good education. He joined the foreign services for the State Department. 他就是我们这个我们亚裔，我们华人是有移民的一个写照。It's a true reflection. Study hard, make good grades, go to a good school, and have a good job. Then why? Sorry, why? Why would you get? You're traveling the world. You experience different cultures. I remember you were telling me how much you love Taiwan. What do you remember about Taiwan the most?
So in Taiwan, 我在那个美国在台协会工作。It's called the American Institute in Taiwan there, and I would work there every day. I would do visas there. But when I would walk out of those doors, when I'd walk into Taiwan, what I loved the most, honestly, was the diversity of culture and especially the diversity of food. Every single day, I would go for my zhengzhu nai cha, and then there was a woman outside who would have that bento box there. If I just had minutes, I would go in and get it. But the thing is, in Taipei, I could get food from all over China, from like Beijing food to like Guangdong food to the spicy Sichuan food, all of it. We had it right there, and there's so much diversity because I think that's the beauty of China is that it's not just one culture; it's so many cultures packed into one, so many types of food, so many different groups, and to see all of that there, I miss it. I miss it every single day. But I can here in Sugar Land, Texas, I can actually go out and get my zhengzhu nai cha, believe it or not, every day.
You see, you understand the importance of diversity. You understand that there's many different types of Asians. 他能够了解到，因为他自己本身住外国，他知道说这个外交不只是像有些对手，只是用这个 military，只是用武力去解决问题。也需要有外交上的努力。See, a lot of people, you know, you can't just use the military and use a stick. A lot of times, the diversity to communicate with other cultures to understand, it takes the diplomacy. That's what you've done, diplomacy, 外交。So my question is, what I don't understand is, I see you age in the last 3 years. As a friend, I feel bad because I see you work every day. Every day, you never stop. And you never lost a passion. People could say that 我们的观众说不定会说你是理想派，或者说你很傻。Like, what do you think? Why don't you just enjoy your travel the world and work and continue that path? Why come back? What it doesn't benefit you. 对你私人是没有的好处，而且最重要就是 What is that 使命感? What is that? Is it a sense of duty? Tell the audience why. Why are you doing this?
So, of course, I love traveling the world. I love learning new languages like Putonghua, you know, like Guoyu, but also like Russian, like Owen, Chibanyayu. I loved all of that. But I also was there because I wanted to represent America and its values. So my father, when he came to America in 1969, he came here for a better life, to create a better life for me and for all of his children, that American dream.The problem is that in the last few years in America, there have been these kind of attacks on people of other ethnicities, of different origins, especially against immigrants, telling people to go back home to where you come from. And my father, he raised me to believe that it doesn't matter what language you speak at home. It doesn't matter where you were born. We all believe in this American ideal. And so when those ideals are threatened, those values that hold us together, because Americans, they come from everywhere in the world. American can look like a Chinese. It can look like an Indian. It can look like a Black or a Latino, but we are all American based on our values. When those values are threatened, I thought the most patriotic thing to do as an American, the most American thing to do would be to come home and stand up for them, because I believe we should all be treated with equality, dignity, and respect here as Americans. So our campaign is based on the principle that diversity is who we are. We can live next door to each other and still be treated differently, but inclusion is what we do. We bring people together. So we became the first campaign in the country to run in Chinese, in Hindi, in Spanish,in Arabic, in Igbo, Yoruba, Gujarati, 27 different languages. No other campaign in Texas history or American history has been run that way, because we believe everyone deserves a seat at the table. We deserve to have a voice in our democracy, including and especially the immigrant communities.
所以的这个竞选总部是美国历史上第一个有27个不同语言的这个助选人员帮他打电话，帮他通跟他的这个选民沟通，因为他知道我们这个社区是不同的族裔，我们华人，光是我们华人就有各种不同国家来的跟不同的这个背景，但是最重要的是我们有包容性，我们要全部都，因为美国是由移民组成的国家，所以他当提到说他放弃在外交部这个很好的工作，回到这个。他的老家，他是休斯顿长大的，他这个延续的这个我们亚裔的传统，他重视家庭教育，他知道说他这个族裔他参选不只是为他自己印度裔，而是为了所有我们这个亚裔跟移民的和谐，最重要就是要这个移民和我们亚裔的社区有得到公平的待遇，因为过去四年真的很乱，美国现在这个内外都很纷乱，加上美中的这个矛盾，他只希望能够恢复对话跟沟通。恢复这个和谐的大环境，他用理智、科学和进步来代表他的选民。I just told our audience, I can't put it as eloquently as you can, when I translate the Chinese, but I'm glad that you have so many Chinese Americans that volunteers for you. They're not paid volunteers. For example, Dr. Helen Xu, she's been there for day one. She's never been paid. I admire her work, and she has never stopped because you're somebody that she believes in.
She was our first volunteer. When I came back here, so here's the thing about the Asian community. We don't have those examples, so it's hard for us to start out. I started out as just one person with no volunteers. Then Helen found me on Facebook. I came to her house, and we started from there, and we started gathering more and more volunteers. But I can tell you, we had the most Asian volunteers of any campaign in Texas history, maybe in America, because we had Indian, we had Chinese, we had Bangladeshi, Pakistani, Korean, Vietnamese, all of us together. And it was a beautiful thing because we were living here. One out of every five people here is actually Asian, but that's not what we see in our representation. We don't see it in our members of Congress, our city council, our governor. And so it's inspiring, not just to me who grew up here, but to that childwho's growing up here right now, that child who was me when I was a teenager, now they see this and they come to us. So there's so many people from the community, business people who come to us, whether they're doctors who come to us, but especially the young people, the high school students, the college students, those are the ones that I'm most happy about. And to see all of the members of the Chinese community supporting us in this way, it makes me really proud because in truth,The best advantage that we have is each other. We know that as minorities, we're always by definition outnumbered, but when we come together in a coalition, that's when we start to build strength in our community. And so I'm honored and I'm proud to have that support from the Chinese community, and I'm proud to support the Chinese community as well.
所以讲的没有错，我们从小在这里长大，我们长大的时候没有看到一个这些台面上的人物，或是这个 elected official， 就这个官员们，是跟我们一样，跟我们的社区出来的，跟我们同种同文的。他讲的没有错，共和党他很多是排除移民，就算你投给他，他也不会支持你。We talked about earlier how the opposition, the other party, the numbers that you brought up earlier was very shocking. Could you tell our audience a little bit about the non-inclusiveness?
Yeah. So, I mean, here's the thing. We have two political parties, you know, like 共和党还有民主党, but they're not the same in their composition. And what I mean by that is, in Texas, for example, there's only one Asian American in the entire Republican Party in Austin. And in Washington, D.C., you know how many Asian Americans there are? Zero. There are zero Asian Americans. So if we want to have representation, the Democratic Party brings in people from every community, Asian, African American, Latino, and we have a seat at the table here. And that's why it's so important for us to form these coalitions, because when I started out, the people who helped me were Grace Meng in New York. She's a congresswoman there. Judy Chu in California. Ted Lieu. These are the people that helped me out. And the reason they did so is because they needed that help. They needed a hand up, a leg up from the Asian community. And they know that we've never had an Asian American ever in Texas history elected. I will be the first. And it's going to make history. And then once I have broken that ceiling, then I can give that hand to other Asian Americans so that they can also fill those roles. That first step, breaking that ceiling is the hardest. And then the opportunities, they keep growing afterwards for the entire community.
他希望带领的是这个，让我们下一代能够看到我们亚裔也可以出来选举，也可以决定我们社区的未来。所以他希望的，他也讲到，身为一个少数民族亚裔来竞选是多么的困难，没有帮助的。但是在全美性的这个国会议员，我们在纽约州加州这个华人选民多的地方选出来我们的华人的国会的代表，从 Grace 到 Ted Lieu， 他刚刚提到都有在私下的帮助他。为什么越区越州从这个美国的另外一边为什么过来帮他？因为他们知道亚裔竞选有多么的困难，他知道共和党希望的是分散我们，让我们华裔跟印度裔、巴基斯坦互相有矛盾，然后这比较好 divide and conquer， 分散我们的这个凝聚力。他希望的是我们要合作，因为身为亚裔，我们本来就是少数民族，我们要在这个美国的这个社会上，我们要能够发声，要能站出来的话，我们需要合作。Like you said, the coalition is so very important. And you know, I have so many more questions that I love to discuss with you because you're a friend, and I want to ask for our friends, our neighbors, our family that still have questions for you, that still have doubts, whether it's from these.Very negative attack ads from the other party, whom I would like to mention does not attend Asian events, refused to answer questionnaires regarding his policies on Asian Americans. It doesn't matter if you're Chinese or Pakistani or India. They don't care about our vote. They don't care. Why is that?
So I mean, here's the thing. I mean, in the same way that I didn't have any Asian Americans to go to in the Republican Party for that hand up, only in the Democratic Party, they also don't do that outreach to our community. I mean, they don't show up. I think those kind of power structures, they've been in there for such a long time, and so they protect them. It's something new to reach out to all these communities. What we were doing by showing up at Chinese American events, it's not the pattern. It's not the ways that people have done things for such a long time here. And honestly, it's easy to find a scapegoat when you have a problem. So with the coronavirus, that's the perfect example. Saying that it's a Kung Flu virus or a China virus, that's not a public health issue. That is just a political issue. And you can see why, because if you can't solve a problem, you have to find a scapegoat, someone to blame. And you can see that the Chinese community, the Asian community is being blamed for that. And it's why you see those attacks on the Asian family in Midland, for example, or those letters being sent out to threaten Chinese American families in Dallas. All of that, it's because it's much harder to accept that we have a problem that we have to deal with than is to try and blame someone else for that problem. And the opportunities that our colleague on the other side could have stood up, could have said something to the Chinese American community, could have reassured them that these things that are being said by our president, it's the president of the United States who is specifically using those terms about the Asian community. He could stand up, but he doesn't want to stand up to his party. And we shouldn't be divided by party. We should be uniting people right now. In the face of great challenges, we unite further. And for me, I think it's important that the Indian community, the Chinese community, we realize that we are much stronger together than we are separate. So that's why it's very important for me to stand up for the Chinese community when they're attacked, because an attack on the Chinese community doesn't just affect the Chinese population. The attack on the Black community doesn't just affect the African-American population. Attack on the Jewish community, the Latino community. This is an attack on all of us, because America should be a country where everybody gets treated equally all of the time. And if you start down that path of allowing that, of standing by while your party, whoever is in your party, attacks someone, then you don't know where it ends. And so for me, I will always stand up for the Chinese American community, because it is my community.
Truly, it saddens me. It saddens me that we have to even talk about it, because if we could appeal to our community to use logic, to believe in science and facts, we don't even have to make this argument, because these are facts. This happened. We were under attack. And like you said, when one gets attacked, we're all under attack. We're all immigrants. To them, we're not Americans. For us to talk about it saddens me. Let me tell our audience what you just said. It is so to the point. I've recorded this. I'm going to start using that, because it really reflects why you decided to come back and run. It also reflects what a lot of us think. 共和党不代表我们的选民，他出来竞选的原因也是因为，当我们被甩锅，他的对手完全支持他的总统，完全是川普的阵营。不管你是不是川粉，不管你支不支持川普。 你都不能够认同一个歧视甩锅的方式，他歧视用这个功夫病毒，他这个在我们这个休斯顿，在这个也是跟斯瑞的选区有重复的这个德州的州议会的选区，共和党的对手也说出了 chink， 说出了这歧视我们华人的字眼，但是为什么他的对手没有去谴责这个竞选人？他为什么没有去谴责总统？为什么我们的票不重要？为什么我们华人受到歧视不重要？斯瑞知道我们中国人，我们华人受到歧视。 所有的亚裔都是一样受到歧视，亚，所以能够感受到他自己也受过歧视，他也知道那个感觉。我们很多是新移民，英文不好的，或者这是英文好的，但是平常并没有参与的，在这边我们觉得受到了压吧，等于像一个 bully 这种恶霸的行为，影响到像我们下一代，你希望我们在这种环境上长大吗？我知道我们很多观众是保守的，我们亚洲人是保守的，我们亚洲人也是。 经济议题很重要，教育议题很重要，但是最终就是谁能代表我们，谁会真的为我们发声 ？I just told our audience it's true. I mean, as Asians, we're conservative by nature, but that conservatism has nothing to do with the Republican Party anymore. They're not the same Republican Party. They do not represent that interest or any of our interests.
Well, I mean, and I will say it's not just a matter of, you know, the president. Some people say it's just one person. My opponent here, for example, one of his max donors, the first max donor that launched his campaign before he even announced, he was talking about chinks. He used the word chinks here in Fort Bend. And when our opponent was asked about it, he says, well, I take pictures with lots of people. This was someone who was at his birthday party, who has pictures with him, helped launch his campaign. It's very hard for them to go against their own party, but you have to. You can't have that in your party. And so the party identification is so much stronger than that identification as an American. If there's someone, even if it was a max donor, if they were calling people like that, then there shouldn't be any room for that in our party. We should stand up for people regardless of their ethnicity. And I think that's why it's so hard for our opponent on the other side to show up to Asian American events or to try to represent the Asian community, because he knows a lot of his supporters are the ones who are specifically attacking the Chinese American and the Asian American community.
I brought it up because it's very hurtful to me, because that is a word that is very derogatory that I grew up hating. And to hear that without an apology or explanation, to hear that happening next to us in this day and age, there's no excuse anymore. 是没有借口的。当对方共和党在这个Fort Bend County 能够用出这种极度歧视的语言，如果是你用同样的字眼去攻击别的族裔 ，if you use derogatory terms on other races, Latino or African American, no matter what party you're with, it won't be acceptable. But yet, what is used on our community is brushed over, it's shoved under the rug. because we don't vote. Our numbers are not, we're not united. This is the one chance. I urge all of you, I beg all of our audience, most, a lot of you have watched this for a long time. You don't have to be a Democrat. You might not know straight, but this is the one time I'm begging, I'm asking you, vote for him. Vote for Democrats. Give them a chance. If they don't do well, then in 4 years, we can vote them out of office. Sri, you're going to stand the test of time. You're going to be able to provide, we could communicate with you directly. You represent our interests. We could reach you directly because you have the campaign staff that can speak our language. You know what it feels like to be everywhere. It hurts me.
Well, so, I mean, I want to say one other thing. It's not just words also. So, you know, when you talk about someone in that way, what you're doing is you're saying that this person is foreign. They're not truly 100% American. When people ask you, where are you from? And they treat you like a foreigner for your entire life here, whether you've lived here 10 years or 20 or 30 years. And the result of it is what we've seen this year. People have told me they've had FBI agents come to their house this year to try and interrogate them to see if they are not loyal to the United States, for example. And you will be treated that way all the time. You know, when people ask me, I'm from here. I was born here in the United States. But when people ask me where I am from, and the point that they're asking is, what country do I really belong to? And I tell them, I'm from here. I was born here. Or when our congressman called me an Indo-American carpetbagger, which is a derogatory term for someone who's not from here. No one would ask that question of him because he looks like he's from here. And you and I, we are just as American as anyone else. My father came here in 1969. And he told me, he said, don't let anyone tell you you're less American than someone else. So to have an Asian American nominated for vice president, for example, that is so powerful because that means that every son, every daughter here, they know that despite the fact their parents came here, they were Americans by choice, not by birth. Their parents were Americans by choice and they grew up here. They are just as American as anyone else. And that's the point, is that we should not be treated like foreigners perpetually because that's what puts us at risk. We could be targeted. We could be threatened whenever there's a problem. Then who is the scapegoat? The person who looks less American or who sounds less American, has less an American name. Your name and my name, they're American names. Your face and my face, they are American faces. Our families are American families, and our culture actually is part of America. We enrich American culture. We don't take away from American culture.
This is the greatest country in the world, and it's because it's built by immigrants. Everyone that comes here, unless you're a Native American, unless you're Apache, please don't tell me that, because don't tell me that you're American. We're all Americans. You came early or you came late. You may speak English as your first language and fluently, or you may not. But we contribute and give to the society just as much as anybody else. 所以刚讲到重点，你不管你新来的移民、旧来移民，尤其是我们英文不好的移民，受到了很大的。你各位有经历过吗？我有经历过，我的父母亲有经历过。哦，因为你英文结结巴巴，这不是你的母语啊。 英文本来就是你第二语言，为什么要歧视你英文这样不好？或是他们对你的对手会说，哦，你们是亚裔，你们是移民，不管你来的多久，你的小孩在这里生的，你的孙子永远都是变成外来的人，他要剥削你权利，他们觉得只有他们才可以控制你的未来，你的税务跟你的外交跟你的医疗，为什么？为什么要给把这个权利送给别人？我们常讲说，做一个堂堂正正的中国人，做中国人，不管你到哪一个国家，你要遵守那个地方的法律，你要执行你公民的义务。 I'm talking to our Chinese American voters specifically because we're traditional. But part of our tradition is to fulfill your duties to your family and also fulfill your duties of as a citizen of where you are. You know, we're responsible, right? This is our responsibility to vote this year. Like I said again, you don't have to vote, ever vote for Democrat. You could identify as Republican, but this is the one year we cannot let this continue because we don't have another chance. We cannot let him and his surrogates from Trump to his supporters, the cultists, to continue this divisiveness. 我们的社区不能再允许他们在四年的动乱，是吧？
Well, so I'm glad you brought that up because when I left the Waijiapu and I came back home, the first thing I was told is that not to talk to Asian voters. Don't bother with the Asian community because they don't vote. And the easiest way to lose an election is to talk to people who don't vote. And I said, maybe they don't vote because we don't bother. The easiest way to never get change is to keep doing the same thing over and over again and expecting different results. And the reason that we get treated like foreigners is because we don't vote. It's a self-fulfilling prophecy, because if we voted in large numbers, then no one could treat us like a foreigner, because we are the ones who choose our leaders. We are the ones who choose our representative. They have to represent us. And so what we did in 2018 by running in 27 languages, we more than doubled the Asian American voter turnout. And so now they have to pay attention to us as a community in a way that they didn't before. Now they have to listen to us and the things that are on our agenda. So for example, family reunification. There are so many people in the Chinese community who are afraid that their family members may not be able to come to the United States if you cut off immigration. If you cut off highly skilled immigrant visas, that will affect our businesses here. If you cut off foreign students here, there are so many Chinese American students here who are threatened this year with being kicked out of the country completely and through no fault of their own, simply by this government. We are going to have a situation where the best and the brightest minds do not want to come to America anymore. That we are not going to have the dynamic economy of America. We are not going to have the innovation of America, the things that make America great. We are going to lose that if we try to cut off this immigration from Asia, which this administration wants to do. We're literally going to cut off our own hand in order to spite our face.
美国是一个顶尖的国家，因为它能够吸引全世界顶尖的人才。相信我们很多观众也是因为念书或在这里求学，进了顶尖的学府或做研究。你有没有想过，美国是因为各国的顶尖人才？但是现在反移民，不要跟别的国家沟通，尤其是反中，尤其是我们很多华人，我们中国来的、台湾来的、香港的朋友，你很多家庭被分隔两地，你没有办法重新团圆团聚，这是一个非常非常不人道的做法。这个 administration， 这个现在的政府跟所他们代表的，不是代表我们的权益。我们要选出我们自己的人选，能够代表我们权益，能够直接沟通，能了解我们的苦楚的人。这唯一的人选就是施瑞普宽。所以谢谢你，我们稍后一下，我们还有很多问题要继续问你。好，谢谢你，稍后一下下。各位观众，欢迎回到我们休斯顿论坛。再次的，我今天很荣幸也很开心的请到我的好朋友施瑞库卡尼来参加我们的节目。施瑞，
哎，大家好。
You know, we want to continue about. I mean, there's so much to talk about. I know you have never stopped working for 3 years. It's very hard to find the time to chat. I want you to be able to tell our people, our Chinese Americans, the voters here, what you represent and why do you know.为什么你能够同情知道我们移民的故事？为什么你知道身为少数民族有多么的困难？还有最重要就是，我们中国人常讲百善孝为先。Your relationship with your parents, with your family, tell us what happened.
Sure. So, I mean, first of all, I think throughout the Asian community, you know, we care about our family very deeply. Family is extremely important. Taking care of your parents, taking care of your siblings. And so I was raised in a very close family. When I was at University of Texas, I was 18 years old. It was a very difficult time in my life because my father got cancer. And I came home to take care of my father. I was in Austin going to university. I had to come back to Houston and I had to take care of him. I had to do his physical therapy, his IVs. As he was getting sick with cancer, I had to take him back and forth to the bathroom, take him to the hospital. And I watched my father get sick and die when I was 19 years old. I was the oldest son. I had to help raise my younger siblings. My mother was on the point of bankruptcy because of this medical emergency. And I had to work my way through university and raise my siblings at the same time because it was so difficult on us. And I don't want other people to have to go through that, what I went through. I don't want a medical emergency to wipe out a family. But our family was able to make it through because of how close we were, because we cared about each other and we knew what our responsibility was. And so I feel that responsibility now to the entire community to make sure that other people who are going through the same things, at the very least, we can make sure that they don't get completely wiped out. So, for example, in Texas right now, 650,000 people lost their health care this year during the pandemic. And there is a lawsuit by the Texas Republicans that will be heard 1 week after the election to take away protection for pre-existing conditions. What do I mean by pre-existing conditions? Diabetes, heart disease, coronavirus is now a pre-existing condition. And I don't think it is smart. I don't think it's moral to take away protection for those pre-existing conditions right now when we're in the middle of a pandemic. I think we need to respect health and we need to respect our families.
所以的父亲也是移民。 然后来了美国，来收拾最好的大学，知名的学府南方哈佛的Rice大学，这个莱斯大学任职教授，在18岁的那一年，他的父亲得了癌症，很艰苦的病魔这个抗争，所以那时候休学回家帮助他的母亲，帮助照顾他的父亲，很不幸他父亲去世了，他继续休学照顾他三个弟弟妹妹，儿子代替父亲的职责，这是孝顺。 他自己本身在那个时候经历过了很多苦楚，他并没有去抱怨，他还是咬牙的把它做完，继续回到学校升学，德州大学、哈佛，然后到外交部任职。我再一次讲，他可以很一帆风顺的继续过他的日子。 He doesn't have to come back and do this. 这个是很辛苦，竞选他是真正的这个没有负担、不欠任何人情的人。所以 you grew up here, but you're not part of the system. You never ran for office. Your opponent, you know, has always been on a taxpayer dime, basically, because you could only be a police officer, I mean, or a military, or run for office. I mean, but you have degrees. You have experience in foreign policy. 你很多经验，外交经验，你可以在外交部继续做下去，或是可以去做这个顾问. You can work for a variety of companies. That would be an easy life. But 因为你成长的环境，让你更知道，尤其是你18岁丧父那一年。 你的家庭出现了很大的经济的危机，你知道医疗保险的重要性。So talking about insurance, a lot of our Asian American neighbors and friends have a concern is that they call it the Affordable Care Act. They keep calling it Obamacare, saying it increased their premiums by so much because we have so many small business owners. 我们都做小生意的，都说哇，这个民主党的 the Democratic Party's policy 是很不公平的，因为增加我们的负担，我们要多付这个 premium。 Could you explain to us why that is not valid?
So I mean, here's the thing. And first of all, I want to say, I don't want to just be, you know, 美国国会议员. I want to be a 代表人 for our entire community because we need to have someone who represents us, who actually knows some of the things that we go through. So as small business owners, for example, you know, we talk about a shop owner or a restaurant owner. So many of us own restaurants right now. Those small businesses, they need that kind of support. And the one of the biggest costs actually is healthcare. It's health insurance for their employees. As you mentioned, the problem is that we pay too much for our healthcare here in the United States. And so we need to bring down the cost of healthcare. We're not increase the cost of healthcare. And one of those things is drugs costs, right? So the drug costs, how many people have gone overseas, go to China, for example, to get their drugs, or go to Mexico to get their drugs because they're too expensive here in the United States. And so that's what we need to do. We need to make sure that we work through the system and we actually strengthen the system and we reduce the cost, especially for those small business owners. We shouldn't be taking away healthcare during a pandemic. I think that's the worst thing. And to be honest, the public option is something that would help a lot of these small business owners as well. Because if you have the public option along with the Affordable Care Act, then that helps to bring down cost and it increases access to everyone. And that's what Vice President Biden wants. What they want on the other side, what my opponent wants, what Donald Trump wants, is simply to take away a protection so that all of those people, everyone has someone in their family with a pre-existing condition, right? Every one of those people now is going to, they're going to suffer because they may have to pay higher costs for healthcare. They may lose their healthcare. And so we don't want to take away healthcare from anyone. We want to bring down costs and increase access to healthcare for everyone.
And that's what you will do.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
各位,我希望他能够回答了你们,我们,尤其做生意的,尤其是开餐馆的,新移民,旧移民,我们都很辛苦的在赚钱。大家都觉得这负担很重,但是他讲到了重点。 你有这个事先有病痛的话，你每一个人都会有认识得到新冠病毒或是有癌症或是生病需要帮助的人。你的保费不需要增加，为什么？因为医药很贵，药很贵。美国的 pharmaceutical company 它这个行业，这个医药厂跟这个国会跟政府有很密切的挂钩。他们这个 special interest group 有这个捐钱控制的这些议员。 所以能够让价钱很高。我们身为移民，我们自己知道，我们回中国、回台湾，或是到墨西哥来的时候，有谁不在这边买 prescription 的那个 drug， 买那个药，就是不需要医生开处方，不需要卖那种十倍之一、十分之一、十分之二的价钱。那东南亚的国家、南美洲都可以买得到，为什么我们要这么做？为什么？因为美国的药很贵，但是这不是证明的。It's directly correlated。你不能说哦，保费很高，那大家都需要有机会能看病，保费要更高。No， 你保费可以降低，只要把这个药的价钱压下来，把这个医疗系统赚的这个私人的医疗系统赚的钱压下来。A lot of these privately funded medical field, the prices could come down. You know, there's a lot of ways to lower the cost to still provide more or better service.
And you can also reduce some of the red tape, the bureaucracy here. I've talked to lots of doctors. For example, during the coronavirus pandemic, we have done more telehealth now. So there's a lot of things that can be done by Zoom, for example, telemedicine that we're not going to go back to that time period before. There's this kind of innovation. So reducing the bureaucracy, reducing the price of drugs so that when we have five people in a drugstore buying drugs, they don't pay five different prices for the exact same drug. They can reduce their price. And that public option is actually very important for those small business owners, because when you start a small business, you don't want to start a healthcare company, right? You want to run your shop. You want to run your business. So this will actually make it easier for those small business owners to focus on their own business rather than worrying about healthcare all the time, because that's not the reason they got into business in the first place.
对，他说的是要他会照顾到这个做生意，尤其是小生意每个人的这个需要的，每个人需要的有点不一样，但是不需要去担心这个税务跟这个 additional cost 这个负担，这个医疗保险的负担。另外他还有个问题，我们要谈到就是现在这个经济，他现在因为 COVID， 我们这个民不聊生，大家做餐馆的或是做生意的，大家开 nail salon 做指甲的，我们心里很明白，我们身边都有认识的人撑不下去了，房租都交不出来。我们要怎么样才能够让我们能够有最好的收入，能够安居乐业 ？How do we bring this economy back? Especially that the administration has brought us to this point.、
Mm-hmm. So one of the biggest things is that、if we want to be able to open our doors again, we have to get the pandemic under control. We can't pretend that it does not exist. So what this administration is doing is basically ignoring the science. It attacks the public health officials. It attacks Dr. Fauci and says, don't believe it. Don't wear a mask. Or my opponent who said masks are communist and un-American. That doesn't help us bring down the coronavirus. So first we need to wear masks because it's the most American thing to do. It's the thing that shows we care about our fellow citizens. We care about our community. We care about our family members. My mother is 68 years old. She lives with me. I care about her, so I wear a mask. Secondly, we have to have that personal protective equipment, not just in the hospitals, but everywhere for nurses, for workers who deal with the public every day, for schools. To get our schools open, we need to have that personal protective equipment, and we have to have that rapid testing so that we get the results back within a few hours. That way, the workers can go back to work, and then we support those small businesses. We support the small shop owner or the person who owns a restaurant, for example. We give them targeted relief, especially for the industries that were hurt. Restaurants, hotels, retail, all of those industries, they need that support. And then once we get past the pandemic, we need to give them startup tax credits so they can scale back up to get back to normal again. I think that is the biggest thing. Some businesses have done very, very well at the top end of the scale, but for the small business owner, which are so many of our Asian immigrants, they have been struggling. They have been harmed during the pandemic. So we need to make sure that we give them that support, control the pandemic, give them the targeted relief and the startup tax credits so that they can get back to normal again, because that's what we all want.
What did your opponent say, that wearing a mask is what?
Communist and un-American.
I need a minute. You know, for the past 3 years, I have never seen the amount of hate, the ruthlessness where they don't even pretend anymore. That, on top of calling carpetbagger, on top of them saying the Asian straw candidate, along with the word chink, this is all happening next to us. These are people we know. These are our neighbors and so-called our friends.各位，我过去三年第一次看到这个老美能够赤裸裸的直接甩锅，说是我们武汉病毒。他的对手公开场合讲，戴口罩是不美国，你不爱国，你不忠心，戴口罩就表示你是共产党。 用这种 muscling 跟 labeling， 用这种贴标签，就是这是对手跟他的组织跟川普 as Master Trump the same way。我们为什么不能替自己想一下？我们用理性的方式啊，我知道大家不理性，你不管你是支持，你是反共还是怎么样，这是我们的群，这个政党，他的对手不在乎你的选票，他也不希望包容你。支持他们的都是一些新的移民，被边缘化，被包容在，被包围，他们被人包围在一起，他们不代表我们华人跟我们选民的这个意愿，跟我们需要的。They do not. You know, I was telling, you know, I don't want to do this. I don't want to divide either, but that's what they do. Your opponent and what they represent, whether it's in the House district or congressional district, or even in state Supreme Court, they don't want to be inclusive. They claim they have some Asian American outreach because they're surrounding themselves by the non-mainstream Chinese Americans. What do I say is that these Chinese Americans that run to there,They may want some kind of position, 做官, you know, they want to be a bureaucrat, they think they're a title, but they have not put in the work, and they surround these candidates where they think they're representing the needs of a community, but when they're not, 他们是边缘人，这些共产党包围在一个小圈圈, it blinded them. See, sometimes I don't know if the candidate really is that oblivious, that openly racist. Then I see the president, then I get it.But locally, we know these people, Sri. 我们认识他们。他们为什么过去这四年来 ，the past 4 years, how could they get worse when our voting base is more diverse than ever? How did it get here?
So I mean, here's the bottom line: is that you know when they talk to us, you know, on the other side, they'll say, "I'll come and take a picture and say I like the Chinese," or "I'll come and take a picture and I like the Indians." And then they'll say, "We're better for the economy." But actually, as we were discussing earlier.Don't take my word for it. Go to Moody's or to Goldman. They've evaluated that actually the Democratic Party is going to be better for the economy in the coming year. So what is it that they actually offer? And what the real test is when we have a challenge in front of us. How do they respond? When you have a challenge like climate change, what do? They say, let's use this as an opportunity to come together with our best and brightest minds and solve this. No, they said, Donald Trump said, this is a Chinese hoax.He said that climate change is not real. I don't believe in the science. It's actually just China attacking us. Instead of coming together to solve our problems, they blame someone. That's what's happening during the pandemic with coronavirus. Instead of coming together around science and medicine and public health, he says it's the Kung Flu virus. He says China did this to us. China did this to us because then people will start to blame the Chinese people, the Chinese community in their neighborhood, rather than their politicians who are sitting there who are not actually solving these problems based on science. So what I say is the way to address all of these problems is to come together, use the best and brightest minds, say this is a problem not for Republicans or Democrats or for Chinese or Indian or white or black. This is a problem for all of us. So let's turn our attention to it, treat it as a common challenge, because the bottom line is when we have a great challenge in front of us, it should be an opportunity to unite us greater, not to divide us further. And so I believe that's the way that we should go forward. So if I am elected, if you elect me, go out and vote tomorrow, every day this week, up until October 30th, election day is on November 3rd. If you elect me to be your representative, I will fight every day to unite us so that we can face our greatest challenges. I think that is what we should be doing as America. That is the most patriotic thing to do, regardless of our background, because that is what makes America truly great.
所以如果你支持他，他会代表我们的群，他会有 open door， 他的门是敞开的，能够随时跟我们的沟通。他会在国会，他会为我们做生意的这个社区，这些小生意 small business owners， 餐馆的老板，他会有特定的解困的方案，拨这个经费资金给这个 target 的这个经济体。OK， 每一个个体户，每一个人都会拿到。就能够度过这个难关。他刚提到了他的对手跟这个共和党从这个联邦到我们 local 在遇到了危机的时候他没有解决这个危机。施瑞他能够解决危机他也会为你解决这个危机。他重视孝道他有重视家庭重视教育他重视经济他也懂得经济。所有的华尔街所有的这个投资大的这个分析师都直接讲民主党上任美国的经济才会更好。另外 基于我们亚裔，基于我们中国人、华人，基本我们一定要支持维护我们群的人，我们要团结。现在是真的是这个家难国难当头，他能够这个 ，Siri 能够这个用他的这个 integrity、character 跟 honesty， 我们投票的时候是选德跟选，不只是选才能，是要选德。他的这个诚实，他的人格，他的这个诚信真的很重要。他代表的是诚信，他的历史、他的背景没有任何一个污点。我们不要再看这些负面的这些广告。我希望各位能够，如果你没有本来没有就没有要投给他，或是本来不想去投票的，再一次恳求，为了自己、为你的孩子、为了你这个长辈、为了你原来的家园、为了不要被歧视，去投下你这神圣的一票。我们非常希望我们下一次见到世卫的时候是恭贺他选上了国会议员，但是不管怎么样，他继续会在我们的社区为我们服务。I just told our audience that no matter what, I hope I see you next, you will be our new United States Congressman representing every single one of us in this district. No matter what, you will always continue to work for this community like you have. I've seen it with my own eyes. I feel the compassion and empathy from you. 我感受到你的热情，感受到你的正直，你的 integrity. 我希望我们的观众跟我们的选民们能够感受到，给世卫一个机会。这是真的是就这四年，我们不能再乱下去了。给他个机会，投他一票。谢谢你们。Thank you, Siri. I thank you. I applaud you, and I thank you for doing this.
谢谢你。I also want to say I'm glad that you use that word represent, because this is about representation. Representation matters, and so I always want you to call me your 代表人, because the important point is we have to have someone who represents us. And 我想代表你们。
谢谢 Siri. You take care.
哎，谢谢你。